A rocky relationship ending in tragedy. We're learning more about a stabbing at a Maui food land that left one person dead and others injured. The suspect is 45-year-old Stephen Schmidt. He's charged with murder and attempted murder. The stabbings happened inside the food land Kehalani in Wailuku. We learned the victim was his estranged wife, and she notified authorities just last month of potential danger. Bridget Namada dug deeper. Bridget?
Joe, we did some digging and learned that not only has Stephen Schmidt had several run-ins with the law, but the victim, his wife, was granted a restraining order against him just days before the deadly incident took place.
This food land in Wailuku, the scene of a deadly crime between husband, wife, and those who tried to intervene. It happened around 6 on Tuesday night. Police tell us 45-year-old Stephen Schmidt started an argument with a man his estranged wife was with inside the store. 24-year-old Kehau Farias Schmidt was stabbed to death. Two males, a 53-year-old Wailuku resident and a 34-year-old Haiku resident, tried to intervene. Both were stabbed but are in stable condition. We looked into Stephen Schmidt's criminal history and found he's been convicted of 6 crimes in the past, including assault, terroristic threatening, and burglary. We dug deeper and found out his estranged wife was granted a temporary restraining order against Schmidt on April 13, a week before the deadly crime. Schmidt was ordered to stay away for 1 year. Nancy Creedman with the Domestic Violence Center says,
1 week suggests to me that her communication, her message to him that she was leaving is a very strong message and oftentimes makes perpetrators escalate their violence.
But Creedman says it's very important for those in abusive relationships to seek help.
Remind them that if they are making plans to leave or they do leave, that a safety plan could be the difference between life and death.
Creedman says domestic violence programs can help a person safely leave their partner.
Because when you are faced with the assault, it's much harder to think. So if you have a plan in place, you're a little bit better able to think.
In a statement, Foodland said they were shocked and saddened by the incident and are cooperating with investigators. The store was closed today and will reopen tomorrow. Bridget Namata, KHON 2 News.